Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate some simple techniques for simulating the motion of falling leaves. So something like the leaves in this little video. You can see they don't just fall, they move around pretty much as you might expect real leaves to fall. And I'll also show you how to use a very simple method for using alpha textures to create less complex models. Because one of the problems with a scene like this is that, as you can see, there are a lot of different leaves in this scene, and therefore if I modelled them all, especially if I gave them thickness, that would be an awful lot of vertices and would certainly be a challenge for my system to render, and would certainly at least take quite a long time to render. Whereas in actual fact this took something like 15 to 20 seconds per frame, which is pretty good. So to begin with, let's model a leaf. So Shift A, and I'm going to add a plane. You can use the images as planes add-on, but I'll do this the manual way. Go into edit mode and I'm going to press W and subdivide so that I've got a few extra vertices, and perhaps subdivide once more and once more again. Not too many vertices, but I've got a few extra ones so that I can put some distortion on this shape. You can go into orthographic mode to make it a bit easier as well, and let's just move it up to the middle of the scene. So looking from above, in edit mode, with all the vertices selected, press U and project from view bounds. Then I've come out of edit mode, gone over to material, this is all in cycles of course, press new, and using the default material I'm going to go to image texture, select open, go to my textures. I've got some leaves textures here, which I believe most of these were downloaded. In fact, all of these were downloaded from cgtextures.com. And one of the great things about these is that you can tell by the grey backgrounds that they've got alpha backgrounds. So in other words, the backgrounds are transparent. You can do this without transparent backgrounds, like these white backgrounds. You just have to use a colour ramp to select for that white background. But I'm going to use the alpha ones because it's a bit easier. And I've actually got a front and back here, so if you wanted to represent different sides to the leaf, you could do it using these, but you'd obviously have to have more than just one layer of vertices. You'd need front vertices, back vertices, and really you'd need to join them together as well, and then you get into the complication of the edges. So unless it's really important, I would suggest just use a single image. So I'll open that image, we'll go to material view, and you can see there it is. If we want to maximize the use of the vertices, I've opened up a new window there in the UV image editor. We'll open our leaf texture, go to edit mode, and you can see we can afford to scale it down a little bit, move it around a little bit, just to get the leaf using the maximum of the vertices. And I could even cut some of these vertices off, and I think I'll do that. We don't need these two vertices here because there's no texture in this little square. So if I press X and delete vertices, you can see that's fine. If I deleted this one, we'd lose this part of the leaf. And obviously what I could do is just move these vertices around and remap, but I'm not going to worry about doing that. So now what we want to do is just give it a little bit of shape. So I'm going to select that central rung of vertices and just pull that down a little bit, and then do the same with these outer ones, and then perhaps pull that end one up a little bit. And you can do what you will. Obviously a dead leaf is likely to be a little bit of a random sort of shape. Not too extreme. I'll set it to smooth shading, and you could of course add a subdivision surface, but that will again add a lot more vertices. So it's up to you how much you do there. Just do a little bit more. Now at the moment, if I bring some lights up and render that, it looks like a leaf, but because we've got a black background you can't tell that we've actually got a problem there. So if I bring up a simple sky texture, now you can see that it's not looking right yet. So we need to do a little bit more with that material. Go to the node editor. So all we've got is the image texture feeding into a diffuse which feeds into the material. So I'm going to add a transparent shader, and then I'm going to add a mix shader and drop that in there, and I'm going to put the transparent shader on the top. And finally, because this has got alpha textures, I'm going to take the alpha output from the texture and use that to control the mix. And then all of a sudden you can see everything's working much better. We've now got all the transparent area missing. If it looks like this when you do it, it's just simply that they're the wrong way around. Just need to swap them over. At this point I'm also going to come over, I'm going to turn preview down to 10 and render to 25, and I'm going to turn caustics off as I don't need them, and that's improved it already. So that's a basic leaf. We probably want to add a little bit more, so I'm going to take the colour output and put that into displacement. See, it's a bit much at the moment. I'm going to add a colour ramp there and just narrow that in a little bit so it selects more for the veins, something like that, and then add a a math node set to multiply, and just turn that down a little bit. If it's the wrong way up, we can just do minus 0.2. Doesn't matter too much because we're not going to see it very close. So this is adding the effect of additional vertices without actually adding them. And then finally, I'll add another mix shader back here and add a glossy shader. Set this to something like 0.01, make sure it's full bright. At the moment I'm quite enjoying this Shirley glossy shader mode. You can try different ones, what works for you. Beckman I think was the default before. Perhaps a little more, and that just gives you a few little highlights and things like that. So that's a leaf, but one of the things we want is for the leaves to have slightly different colours relative to each other. Now obviously I can just create multiple leaves and colour them differently each, but I'd rather manage the textures and materials as one material rather than lots of different ones. So I'll show you an extra little trick. I'm going to add in an object info node. And you'll notice one of the options in there is called random. I'm going to use that. I'm also going to add a color mix node. And I'm going to put that there, which is in between color of the image as it travels on. Now I'll bring it back here where we can see it. I'm going to set this to color, and then we can play with color here. At fully one, that gives us a very red leaf. At zero, that gives us a very yellow, slightly green leaf. We can then take this random and plug that into there. And each time it creates a particle based on this particle with this material, it will assign a new random mix level, so the colour will be slightly different. And of course you could have several of these in order to have more colours to choose from. You use a colour ramp to determine whether you pick one colour or the next. But if we just leave that there for the moment, and when I did this for the animation, I actually created about 8 leaves, but I'm just going to create 2 for this demonstration. And you can create as many as you wish. So here I've got 2 identical leaves. I'm just going to modify their shapes slightly so they're not completely identical. And obviously you can do more or less of these as you see fit. But they've got the same material on them. It's important that these are in the same layer as the main scene. But we obviously want them out of the camera view. You can see the camera's looking here, so I'll put them about there. I'm going to bring the graph editor up. Some of you may be guessing what I'm going to do now. Before we use that, I'm just going to add my particle generator now. So I'm going to add, it doesn't really matter what shape it is, but I'm just going to use a plane. Scale it up, display my camera so I can see where it is. These other shapes are just some lights, some default lights. They're not really important, I'm not going to use them for this. So main thing is to put my plane just out of view of the camera. The reason for that, I'm scaling on the X a little bit there, the reason for that is because if you had the plane in view, or for example if you used a volume of the plane for the particles, you would see the particles being created, so they just appear. And what we want is just for them to be falling. So I'm having them created just outside of the view of the camera. So what I'll do now is I'm going to select my 2 leaves, Control G, and we'll set them to a group called Leaf Group. And you can see they've got a green line around them at the moment. We've got more to do to them, but I'll just show you what else we're doing first. So this is my particle emitter. I'll give my leaves a name, I think. Click particles and then say new. We're going to actually add 2 particle systems. One of them is going to be a low number of leaves and the other one will be much more dense leaves. Leave it on emitter. While I think of it, come down to here and unclick emitter, which means this won't be visible in the scene. I'm also going to add a lamp, which will be a sun. Up to you how you have it. I'm going to have it fairly, as it were, towards the horizon. And I put multiple important sample on. Make it ever so slightly yellow, and we'll give it a strength of 3. And the shadow size, we'll make that 0.01. Camera, I'm actually going to rotate on the X up slightly because I don't want to see the horizon, and then just lift my plane up a little bit. Under dimensions, I'm going to turn border on, which just means it won't render what's out here. You can see we've got a very simple sky there at the moment. I've got other tutorials that show how to make more interesting skies. And if we click play, they're not visible yet, but you can see there are particles being rendered and falling down. So let's make those particles the leaves. In our particle system, come over to here under render and say group. Select our leaf group, select rotation and pick random. We'll add a little bit of randomness to the size, and it looks like the size needs to be quite a bit bigger as well. And we can now see we've got some leaves just falling straight down. If we render that, there they are. I think we'll turn the brightness of the sun up a little bit. And of course what we can do, I think I'm just going to add another little bit to the material. We want light to actually be shining through as well as bouncing off. So before the glossy, I'm going to add another mix shader, then add translucent shader. That takes the same color. I think I'm going to make that an add shader. It's up for debate whether it should be an add or whether it should be a mix, but add is a nice easy one to use. And then under color, add a gamma node to this shader and increase the number slightly. So all that really does is any light that passes through is slightly dimmer than light that just bounces off. And now you can see a slight translucence. You can make them less translucent by increasing that number. So let's just enhance them a bit. But obviously we've still got a problem here because they're all at the same angle. So to begin with, let's select rotation on here and we'll say velocity normal, but add a little randomness to it for rotation this is. And let's see what that does. And you can see right away they've got a little bit of rotation on them. I'll put some randomness on the phase. And I think we need them to fall a little more slowly. So we'll come down to field weights and we'll turn gravity down. We'll try 0.1, that might be too low. We'll go for 0.3 for gravity. But we need to make them last longer, so we'll put 500 under lifetime. And you can see they're actually being thrown upwards, and that is because when they're emitted, they're being pushed up. So that's under velocity. If we just set that to zero, they'll then just fall. They won't have any initial upward velocity. But we can add a little bit of randomness to that. And then we'll turn the gravity down a little bit more, increase the number of frames, and we'll turn the number of particles down quite a bit as well. For this one, we don't want too many. So now you can see we're just getting a few leaves at first falling through. They're not doing anything, there's no continuous rotation visible on them. So we'll add some random angular velocity and we'll make that dynamic as well, which means it can be affected by things. So you can see then that they're now starting a little bit of rotation on there. Randomize the size a little more. So we're starting to get some motion on them now, but they're still just basically falling. Now there are two things I'm going to do. I'm going to add a force and I'm going to add some movement to the particles themselves. We'll start by adding the force just to so that you can see what that does. And we'll add, you could use a wind, but I would suggest using a turbulence force. Put that there. We need to make sure that the force is on the same layer as particles, otherwise it doesn't work. And we need to make sure that it's strong enough to affect the particles. And you can see immediately we're starting to get much more tumbling now. And that may be enough. It can be a little jerky. Depends really what you're trying for. You can add some flow to it. Don't put too much on, and that will then start to sweep the leaves around. And you can affect the size, in other words, the frequency of the noise. And you can see now there's leaves following little paths. So I'll turn that flow. You want some of that, but not too much. So that's quite nice. But very often with leaves, as they're falling, you get a little bit more. I think I'll turn that flow down a bit more. You get more sort of oscillations backwards and forwards. We haven't really got that. Now I could put another turbulence force on there with a higher frequency, but what I actually did was I added shape keys. So if we look from a distance, we can really see what that turbulence force is doing. And you can see it's even affecting it up here. Maybe the strength is a little high actually. So you can see they're tumbling around quite nicely, but it's not enough in itself. You can add some effects by adding a little bit of damping and drag, but you'll have to determine for yourselves whether that's really what you want. It's really just a matter of playing with some of these things. So the main way that I added that little higher frequency movement to the particles was by using shape keys. So going to the object data for the particle with one of my master particles selected, click plus against the shape key and get a basis, and then click the plus again. Then go into edit mode and move it. So I'm just going to move it this time just on the x-axis to one side somewhat. But that was in edit mode, that's the important thing. Come out of edit mode. Now when I move this value, you can see it moves to one side. Change the minimum to -1. So what that now means, it'll go either way. Good. I'll set it back to 0. And then I'm just going to press I, hovering over that. That's just to give an initial keyframe. Now what I can do, with the menu on the right hand side visible, you press N to bring that up. Click Add Modifier and say Noise. You can see there's a little bit of noise there. If I press play, you can now see it's jiggling backwards and forwards. So we can see here we've got scale, strength and offset. So we probably want a little bit more noise than that. So let's increase the strength. But looking on this scale on the left, we only need to go from 1 to -1. It doesn't matter too much if we go more, but it means that it will clip. So it will stop for a moment and then start moving when the noise waveform comes back in. I'm going to also turn the scale up to slow it down so that it's smooth. And you can see I'm still going over 1 there, so I'm going to turn the strength back down a little bit. Now you can see I've got some nice random movement, and I can just put a random offset on it, whatever. The reason being, each time I use this, the same initial noise pattern will be used. So I've got some random movement there. Perhaps I want it a little slower still. If we look up here, we can see that's key value 1. So I'm now going to press plus, and I'm going to add, I'm going to stop it and put it back to the beginning. I'm adding another shape key. Do exactly the same thing. Go into edit mode. This time, I'm going to move it on the Y. Come out of edit mode, set the minimum to minus 1. Press I, make sure that key value is selected. Add a modifier and noise, and again make sure that the strength takes it up to roughly plus minus 1. Put a random offset on there, turn the scale up somewhat, press play, and you can now see we've got random movement in two axes. And as you've probably guessed by now, I'm going to add a third shape key, go into edit mode, and I'll push it down this time, minus 1. I select that shape key, add noise, adjust the strength, adjust the scale, give it a random offset, and press play. Now you can see it's moving all over the place. If you find it sticks at all, it will be because you've gone over the limits. You can either reduce the strength, or you can just increase the limits here a little bit. And you can actually add a fourth shape key as well, or fifth. It's up to you how many you add, because you can rotate it. Now, word of warning about rotation. Each of these vertices are being moved to their target within the shape key by the most direct route, a straight line. So when you rotate this, think about what that means. You may just be able to see there, I did a small rotation, and there's actually a distortion taking place, because although it ends up the same as it started in terms of its overall shape, it's just rotated, to get there it doesn't actually rotate, it just sends all the vertices along a straight path. So you can't really do a full rotation or anything like that with this method. You can just put a small rotation that isn't really noticeable, unless of course you're simulating something that's flexible. So other than that, following the same technique, I have the scale fairly small to start with so that I can see what I'm doing, and then turn the scale up, and you can see we've got a small variation. You can probably do more or less, depending on how obvious it is that the object is being distorted. So I'll just do the same for the other one. And now you can see, just looking at them here, they're floating around and wobbling quite interestingly. So if we have a look how that affects the particles in the scene, you can see we're now getting that little jerking, sort of seesawing backwards and forwards, a little bit more like a leaf falling. And obviously you need to play with and adjust things like the turbulence force. I'm going to turn that down now so it has less of an impact on the movement of the particles. And then really the final thing is just to add, for my animation, a second particle system. This one starts at frame number 1. We'll add a new particle system. We'll copy the initial one, but then click the 2 to make it unique. We'll call this one high. We'll start this one at 100 frames, and we'll tell it to create 1,000 particles. So if we play that, you can see we just get a few particles dropping down. Looks like we may need to increase the gravity. So I'm going to select low, and I'm just going to increase the gravity on there a little bit. Go to 0.25, and I'll do the same for high as well, just to bring them down into the scene a little quicker. There they go, and then at 100, we get a lot more leaves created, and down they come. And if I render that, you can see there they are. So I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, let me know. You could use this for things like snowflakes just as easily as leaves. You can even have them fall onto a surface by adding a plane and then adding collision, and the particles will then settle onto that surface. I've shown how to do that before. So I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.